Republican Congresswoman Nancy Mace, who recently endorsed Donald Trump for president, allegedly wanted to get punched in the face by MAGA supporters during the January 6th riots so that she could become the face of anti-Trump Republicans and also have a legitimate or, you know, credible reason for why she's so against Trump. Now, according to three sources who heard the comments firsthand, Mace used these exact words. She wanted to go get punched in the face. Now, one former aide told the Daily Beast, she literally begged us to let her leave the office and head to the floor so she could get punched in the face and get media attention. That's word for word what she requested. So I just wanted to note that we're getting one side of the story, and you're getting one side of the story from former aides and staffers. There might be elements to this story that we are not privy to as a result of that. And I have personally seen certain pieces by the Daily Beast that were, let's just say, dishonest and were meant to smear certain people. I'm giving you that warning because I don't know what the truth is here. This is what three different sources who are close to her are alleging, but.
Yeah, so this is in other places too, but you're right to come in with that heavy warning. And Daily Beast's number one go-to move whenever they want to attack a progressive or a Republican is office rumors.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Right.
Totally.
So that's
they love the office rumors
because it's so easy. You just have to find one disgruntled person or a couple of disgruntled people for whatever reason, right? And then have them go, "Oh, you wouldn't believe it."
And everyone's disgruntled at work. It's work. You know, it's like the easiest story to break. Just find some colleague or an employee who's like especially disgruntled and loose-lipped, and you'll get a story.
Okay, I don't know if he meant to do this, but Skip is our director today. And when Anna said, "Everyone's disgruntled at work," he gave like a big thumbs up. Okay, it's our reporters called Skip.
No, don't tell the Daily Beast, okay? Anyway.
Okay, hold on, I wanna say something about Nancy Mace. So we're gonna get to her flip-flops on Trump, which are hilarious. But I'm gonna shock the world here, she gets it. Okay, that whole thing about getting punched in the face makes a lot of sense in modern day politics. So getting the punch in the face is the unfortunate part, but she's not wrong that A, it would have gotten her a ton of media attention. B, media attention is a currency of politics. And C, it would have greatly increased her grassroots fundraising. So this is now politics is all about getting media attention. And the right wing understands that so much better than the left wing or the Democrats do. And everyone on the right wing now has podcasts.
It's so embarrassing.
Yeah, but that's the reality of today. And it's the reality of politics overall. Politics is all about branding. What is your brand? And do people know your name, i.e. your brand, right? And do they associate something positive with it? So Nancy Mace has been trying to get her name in the news every single day, literally, that we have a part of that in this story as well. And honestly, it's logical. The problem with the right wing is they use it for just their own selfish greed and corruption, etc. But if you got that media attention and they use it to help people, that would be amazing. But that hasn't happened yet, outside of maybe Bernie Sanders.
So she allegedly felt that getting punched in the face by one of the January 6th rioters would lend credence to her lack of support toward Donald Trump. The source continued that there were several of us in the office who heard it, and she had been in office for 3 days, if that tells you anything about her motivation. So now Mace ultimately ended up backing off the idea of getting punched in the face. She got some pushback from her staff. And when the Washington Post asked Mace for comment, she didn't directly address the episode, but said this, "What you write doesn't pass for real journalism," which makes me think that maybe what they're alleging is true.
Yeah, of course.
Like, no. Why not just address the allegations?
Yeah, look, Klobuchar was tough on her staff, right? And Nancy, this story is originally from the Washington Post. It rings very true, right? So yes, sometimes, like when they attack Marianne Williamson on the office drama, nonsense. Total, guy's such a, I mean, I can give you many other examples, but when they do it to progressives, it's almost always horse crap, right? So rare occasion you'll see one guy, oh yeah, okay, that he actually did do that, etc., and that's bad. But 9 out of 10 times, it's just a smear job to help the establishment. But in this case, it looks like they got the goods. And there are 3 different sources, and again, it started originally from the Washington Post.
Yeah.
So, and you can tell from her appearances too, and they say, she wants to be in the news every single day.
Right.
She wants either a daily appearance on television or for people to be talking about her.
Just one other thing that came out in the reporting. So apparently in a strategy memo that she wrote in 2021, just after the Capitol insurrection that she repeatedly expressed had troubled her greatly, she described herself as the freshman thought leader on federal issues, officially dubbing herself National Nancy.
That's hilarious.
I think that's the most incriminating thing in all of this. Okay, like who nicknames themselves?
Well, unless you're doing it like Muhammad Ali did, with like a smile on your face, like with a wink.
You're not being super serious about it.
Yeah,
like you're having fun.
Yeah, you're doing it with a wink. You're doing it sarcastically. You're having fun with it, right? But if you come in and go, I am now National Nancy. I want everybody to call me National Nancy.
What does that even mean, though?
Like that is like the worst nickname too. Okay.
Now, despite initially condemning Trump on the Hill and in the press, it was reported in October that Mace has been privately suggesting to her Republican colleagues that she may have an actual shot at being Trump's vice president.
What?
Despite the fact that one source close to the former president said he absolutely hates Nancy Mace. Her staff handbook also illustrates how focused she is on getting media attention. And that, of course, is what Cenk was referencing earlier. Aides are expected to send out at least one press release and book the congresswoman and book the congresswoman on one television show daily, which is more than what most Congress people do. And a former Mace staffer said this: "It is not normal for a member to prioritize media and comms over actual legislation like that. In my experience with her and in other offices, comms serves to promote what the member is doing legislatively. In Mace's office, legislation served to get her more media opportunities."
Yeah, but look, that's the one where I go.
You love media, like you love.
No, I do, and I'll tell you why, guys.
I hate it.
No. It's ironic because we do media together.
I know. I like doing my media. I like doing my show. Like media requests make me so miserable.
I love them. Keep them
coming. I know.
Okay, so here's why. Because you want to get your message to more people, different people. And so in her case, like if I was in Congress, I would do the same thing as her, except use it for good. Would I tell the staff, get me an interview every day? Of course I would. Why? Because I'd be fighting for things like paid family leave, higher minimum wage, etc. And when I get on there, I would find a way to say something that was put in a way that's controversial enough, but is actually surrounds an issue that is very, very popular, so that you can get more attention to that issue so that you can have it passed. Now, she doesn't care about legislation, but to be fair to Nancy Mace, neither does anybody else in Congress.
Like, yeah, that's true. That's true. So it's just media attention for media attention's sake. And that's also the reason why, rather than passing legislation, much needed legislation, like the migrant crisis that Republicans purport to care so deeply about, they won't pass legislation on it. They are purposely serving as obstructionists because they want to allow for Trump. I just read a really interesting piece on this. They want to give Trump that issue to campaign on.
Yeah.
So they're intentionally serving as obstructionists in passing much needed immigration reforms just to do a little favor for Donald Trump so he can increase his chances of defeating Joe Biden. But look, wall to wall nonsense. And this isn't just indicative of the Republican Party. I see it with Democrats too. They love the media attention. They love to hold hearings because when you're holding hearings, you're not actually legislating and you're not doing anything to govern the country and serve the best interests of your constituents. You know that the media is gonna cover the hearings. It gives you a moment to get a good soundbite in. And then you get more attention for that. And that gives you the illusion of governance. In reality, they do nothing. And it really upsets me.
Yeah,
it really does.
Last two things on it. So think about the second half of Biden's term. So the Republicans win the House. And I told you guys, the minute they won the House, I said they will do absolutely nothing going forward in Congress. And then the mainstream press had these nonsense conversations about what the Republican agenda was, what could Biden get done. I was like, they're not even gonna try. What are you guys talking about? Don't you know anything about politics? And you know what's happened since then? Sorry, but I was 100% right. They haven't even tried. There are a bunch of Republicans, we showed it to you earlier in the week, yelling in at the House going, are we gonna try to pass any bills? Now they want right-wing bills passed. They're not even trying for that, right? And the Democrats, they don't wanna pass anything. So the minute the Republicans won the House, Biden had a party. He's like, yes! Because he didn't want to pass paid family leave and higher minimum wage and all those things that he promised. If he wanted to, he would have tried in his first 2 years. He absolutely positively does not want those things passed. So when the Republicans won, it's a perfect excuse. So the Democrats are proposing nothing, and the Republicans are proposing nothing. So that's why they've all had these stupid, dumbass hearings, because they don't want to get anything done. Because you know why? Their donors love the status quo. If you're already at the top, you don't want to change anything. That's why you love the status quo. And all of them represent the people at the very, very top.
Right, and so while they're enjoying their positions at the very, very top, and while they use their positions of power to enrich themselves through trading individual stocks, taking bribes, all of that, what do you think is happening to the rest of the country? Why do you think you have a growing American population that thinks that we're headed toward a civil war? Or more importantly, a growing percentage of Americans who think maybe democracy really ain't all that it's cracked up to be.
Yeah, you know,
they're destroying the country. Like, they don't realize, maybe they do realize it and they don't care. I have no idea what's in their hearts and minds. What I do know is who they look out for first and foremost is themselves. As the rest of the country wastes away, as everything continues to deteriorate, I'm so angry about it, because again, I feel like we're headed for an iceberg, especially when it comes to the growing body of Americans who want a civil war and don't believe in democracy. And it's misplaced anger. I understand the anger, I feel the anger. We have to change the laws pertaining to our members of Congress to ensure that there's accountability there and that their jobs are seen as and acted upon as public servants. But that's not happening right now.
Yeah. So look, why don't people want to support democracy as much as they have in the past in American history? Because they're like, what democracy? So if you're an average person, you're like, well, I want all these different things that are, you know, and I've listed all the polls for you guys. Dozens of proposals are over 2/3 of Americans. We all agree, almost all economic issues. And they never ever get it. Mm-hmm. So they're going, if this is what you call democracy, then I hate it. But it isn't. They perverted democracy because the Supreme Court legalized bribes. And the media never tell you about it. That's why I get so frustrated at the media. The number one most important thing that decides politics is money. And the media never talk about money. It's a total joke. Just like Nancy Mace, who's also a joke, who's flip-flopped on Trump now 3 or 4 different times. I hate him, I love him, I hate him, I love him. Now she's trying to be his VP after criticizing him before. Total utter fraud. In the bonus episode,
Casey DeSantis likes to travel in private jets because traveling commercial is pretty miserable. So I don't know why it's a big deal.
Well, but the amount of money is an amazing fact. Right. So tyt.com/join, we'll see you there. Thanks for watching the video, guys. We also love it if you hit the join button below, because that makes you a member. And members allow us to be independent, honest. We could be as progressive as we want, no corporate media influence. And that's all because of you guys. We love doing the show with our members. Hit the join button, become one of the Young Turks.